guys, it's James here. Welcome to my Where from the Wild guide on how to read Calamity Gan. I will be doing a separate guide on how to defeat them, but so I don't have the DLC and all the DLC armor. I have the Phantom Ganon, Royal God, Sad's Helm, Warrior's Hood, Elendor, Stuff, Phantoms, all that. But let's get a weapon. Why do I have a Bokoblin arm? Let's equip the Demon Carver. Anyway, since I can only record for 18 minutes and 8 seconds, I might have to do two parts on this. But I have my Hylian sealed. I have a Royal Ball, I only have 11 arrows, but I have 27 ancient arrows, a Killing Guardians, and yes, I have a Forest Dweller's Bow with 5 Salt Burst. For my armor, I have the Champion's Tunic level 2, Soldier's Helm level 2, and Soldier's Greaves level 3. The Hanging Tunic is the only and I've upgraded to max, and I'm not going to equip it because it only gives me 6 more points of defense. There's also a major test of strength somewhere here. Let's just equip Stasis Plus. Make sure this guy doesn't see us, and this is the worst time for Wayne. Actually, I have an idea. There we go. And he sees us. So yeah, parrying a laser at a decay to go hold him and instantly kill it. And outside I have this much wings on us. Then Maze does follow the path, look out for all the guardians, and you're good to go. I'm actually going to keep my Demon Carver as I keep on thinking I'm locked on with that little thing. So, I'm pretty sure we can swim up in the waterfall. So, let's just equip my Sora armor. And we have reached the first gatehouse. Now I do believe we can just skip them, although if you have ancient arrows you can fight the minor last spawns. Or just shoot it, although if you shoot it with an ancient arrow you won't get any loot.
Urgosa's Fury is ready.
I am looking out for that guy. Yes, I know this is more of a gameplay than a walkthrough, but I'm still showing how you can get past all this stuff. There's some guardians there. So, equip our ancient arrows, our forest dweller's bow, just in case. Get the ancient curious back on. Just jump up here and hide behind the mallet. Use my last of all the scale, and I'm not gonna kill him. Although we do have to be careful. Actually, forget it, let's kill him. If you shoot the guardian in the red spot of an ancient arrow, it will one-shot him. Now, we go in the correct way. This should lead straight to the calamity after some winding paths and some guardians. I just feel like killing this guy, so let's whistle. And goodbye. Now just go and watch him explode, which doesn't hurt me. There will be some guardians up there. Oh, and also, oh, that made a test of strength in here I mentioned earlier. What did that? Basically, it requires lighting a campfire somewhere. That's my insane parry skills. Let's use this, where basically, like, if you hold down moving and whistle and spam the one button and optionally the throw weapon button, you can run with infinite stamina. Let's just eat something to get our health back up. And I have no idea what I am going to do. We can clear out the malice. Guardians can be super annoying in work. And you know you can kill him, but they're out of reach. Or at least for your parrying. Let's just run. Eat the palm fruit. Wait, actually, let's eat. Do I have anything with a good defense up? Yeah, let's. It's 5 armor ones to cook it. Actually, this one has 3 armor ones and iron swoon. And it has defense up level 3. Get away from the malice. The malice drains your health like mad. Am I still getting hit by these? We have made it. Let's just save it here and actually let's go in and fight the calamity. First off, do this. Let's equip these. Oh, by the way, this is a royal recipe that you can find somewhere in Hyrule Castle. Basically, you mix any 2 fruits with that. So, first off, yes, I legit have 115 damage weapon. Let's equip our Lizard Twine Boomerang and enter the Sanctum. Oh, and by the way, one of the gods you form is in the second room of the Sanctum. Oh, and by the way, if you saw the store by my safe fire when I saved all the wrong, you know that I already beat the game. There's also this cutscene. We could skip if we wanted it, but I ain't gonna do that. Oh, and by the way, if you look up down the Clanty Ganon, I do see the sacks actually like broken. And it's these little details that make Breath of the Wild so good. I'm not gonna look up in this fight, but whatever. And if you're expecting separate videos like Clanty Ganon and Reach to the Sanctum, my second remake might have to do it. Although I have 8 minutes and 4 seconds of recording left. So if you haven't got a knowledge fight beast, you have to fight the blind beast before the calamity and his health before. If you don't have any fight beasts, then you'll fight the blights in this order. Wind blight, water blight, fire blight, thunder blight. And if you've done 1, 2, or 3 divine beasts, you'll just leave out the blight of the ones you've done. And also, we get this awesome cutscene. Yeah, they all shoot the lasers at Hyrule Castle, and then Clancy Ganon realizes that he made a mistake using to fight the Dingle after he got it by Beast. Like, he could have just went into his Beast form and just destroyed him while he was weak, but I guess the game has to be possible. So, it may look like he's down, but he ain't. I'm just gonna skip because I don't want to have to split this video into 2 parts. Oh, I have my master sword. Ow. Now, we've done Robert. We have high defense and 3 defense up things. Well, I think we've done more. But actually, we still saints and arrows. Taste the wrath of ancient arrows, Ganon! We could just spam our ancient arrows if we wanted to. Let's stasis him for fun. And he's practically invincible in this state, so what we have to do is that we're gonna have to parry his laser. If I can actually parry just once. And I don't think stasis in him will change the fact that he's invincible. Am I messing up my parrying? It's probably because I'm jinxing it, I think. You could have stopped I'm on him with stasis plus while he's down, but I ain't gonna do that. I kinda don't like how the game forces you to have good parry skills just to beat the calamity at 1 point, but whatever. You missed. Oh, you can now fire your little lasers at me now. And you're done. The first time I did this, I actually killed him by parrying his laser. Don't worry, it looks like he gets defeated, but actually he turns into Beast Ganon. And then you get a random horse. Well, I think it's a random. I've seen people having a pony on it. Lots of people. You can watch these cutscenes on other videos if you want. That means you can exit this and of all the horses, why the giant horse? And why spawn the light bow in the most awkward place underneath Dark Beast Ganon? you get an extra slot just for this ball. We can keep this outside battle by sidestepping off our horse and looking forward, but then if you say you'll be stuck in Glitz Tyrone forever. And then he sees sort of text us that we need. I did not mean to do that. Get back here, giant horse. So I did name him Fight Duck, as he has 5 stars in strength. Fighting Ganon with Ganon's horse. And people consider this to be Ganon's horse, as he looks like the type of horse Ganon would like. I may have to do a part 2 just to finish off Dark Beast Ganon. Then really, there ain't any post-game, sadly. You just get that star on your save file. And even though I've defeated him 4 times before, I can't get any more stars. So now that we've done that, he'll spawn him on the other side, then run under him, my defense has ended, so let's eat another defense up food. This one, which is basically the same as before. What I like to is us go in circles, and then when he looks at me, I just go the other way. My time is running out. So I'm going to have to cut this into 2 parts. Thank you for watching part 1, and I'll see you next time.